Alors, my name is Robert Romain. My gym is Platinum Hybrid Center, a new gym. Alors, my opponent is Ben Conway.
Est-ce que tu en sais un peu plus sur lui ?
Non, non.
Tu sais rien ?
Non, rien. Alors, ma famille, ma femme, mes filles, ensuite mes coachs, David, Loïc, Yo, et tous mes partenaires d'entraînement.
And his opponent tonight, ladies and gentlemen, fighting out of the red corner, Ben Conway!
Okay, my name's Ben Conway. I fight out of Urban King's Gym down in King's Cross. I'm fighting Romaine Roberts. Don't know much about him, unfortunately, but should be good fun. No predictions, I'm just going to go out and enjoy myself.
Is there anybody you want to thank?
Yeah, just my training partners, especially my friend Simon, who's fighting as well tonight. My friend Dan, who's also fighting tonight. Coach Wendell, all the guys down the gym who've coached me, who've sparred with me, who've done everything they can to get me ready for this. I can't thank them enough. And my friend Jenny for being a constant source of moral support.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is fight number two. In the blue corner, he has a record of 2 wins, 4 losses, and 1 draw. He stands at 175 centimeters tall. He's a boxer and a grappler, and he fights out of the Platinum Gym in Paris. Romaine Roberts! And his opponent, out of the red corner, he has a 1-fight record of 0 wins and 1 loss. He stands at 1 meter, 75 centimeters. He has a kung fu and grappling background, and he fights out of the Urban King's Gym. He is Ben Conway!
Apprehensive, but he's from a sand shell background. I talked to him in the change room.
Oh, Romaine Roberts is him with a nice high kick, and he's going straight in for the ground and pound. That's
no
a great right
around.
High kick. I've seen this guy fight before. The Frenchman, Romaine Roberts, is very good. We saw him last time on Killer Cam, and he did well. And it's a scramble for position on the floor at the minute, Alex. And Romaine lands inside, man. And what's he going to do from here? I think this is going to be a good one. The nerves have probably gone from Ben now, and he's right into the fight. It's just like being in the gym, so let's see what these two guys have got. A slip there from Romaine Roberts, but straight back to his feet.
Ben's still a little bit rocked, if I'm not mistaken. He seems a little bit apprehensive.
Yeah, he will be. That was a fast pace to the start of the fight, but I think he's relaxed now, and he's going for what he knows. A nice double leg takedown. He's moving and transitioning nicely, trying to get that side mount, but Romaine's not going to let him have it that easy. Okay, Romain went for the armbar, and now he's going for a triangle attempt. I can't see if the arm's in. And this will be a good time to go for submissions, Alex. Nice and early in the fight where you're not so slippery. Yeah, we can't, in the semi-pro bouts, we've got 3 4-minute rounds, and you can't do heel hooks and certain locks that you can do in the pros, but that triangle would have been perfect. Oh, and Romain transition for that armbar, very slick, right around the back, around the top. If he can get that right leg over his face, this might be on, and no, Ben escapes very nicely. Back to their feet now. And it looks like Ben's gained a lot of confidence now, and he's on top.
What was that? What happened there?
Not too sure. Some sort of issue with the gloves, but there don't seem to be an issue now. The only issue is the gloves coming down on Romain's face, and he's got to try and stop this.
It's like Ben's woken up. Oh, I'm in a fight. I better get mean.
Yeah, that's right. And it's working good for him now because he's turned this round around. This is going to look impressive to the judges. He's on top for quite a lot. He's thrown a good few strikes. A lot. This round depends on whatever happens from now on. As being the guy on the bottom, the control, you can see Robert's got an overhook and a nice sweep that he's just finished. And now he's back on top. Last 10 seconds of the round, so Robin needs to do something quick to impress these judges. He's looking for an armbar again, Alex. Nice first round. Round two, here we go. Who would you give that last round to, Alex?
Robert just inched it.
I think so for me too. But I think more of the effective aggression has come from Robert. He's landing the cleaner shots and gone for way more submission attempts. I think he just might have pinched that round for me. Nice jab. Yeah, I think Ben wants this on the floor, doesn't he? Look, he goes for the takedown straight away, but gives his back in the desperate attempt there. He's picked that ankle and he's turned that around nicely. That was a lovely transition. And now he's on top inside mount. This is all good for Ben. You can see his judo back. You can see a lot of the hip tosses. And unfortunately, that's what gave his back. But he's managed to turn it back around and he's on top at the minute. So he's stuck in the half guard here. So he's going to want to pass that leg and try and transition to full mount preferably. But at the minute, he's just trying to soften him up with some blows and try and get that half guard open. That's in France. Robert comes from, he's come over from France a couple of times to fight on the show. They've got a big team that come from out there, and they're all pretty good on the ground, these French guys. Yeah.
I might have that wrong.
Urban Kings, actually, but yeah, so you can see his cornerman. He's got good cornermen there, Dan Edwards and Wendell Lewis, I can see in the corner shouting good advice, and he seems to be listening well and controlling this fight in the second round. Spread his guy out nicely, he's got the back, he's laying down some shots. Ben's turned his fight right around and he's definitely winning at the moment.
He's a grinder. He's not massively explosive, but he's just grinding that out.
In the first minute of this fight, I would have put my money on Robert, but now Ben is controlling this fight impressively as well. Just trying to see if he's going to sink in the choke or is he going to be happy to just stay there and strike. And I think he's doing the right thing at the moment here because he's only going to knacker his guy out on the bottom. There's only so many strikes that the ref's going to let him take before he steps in. But he's doing a good job. He's turned back in. He's still in a bad position. He's in the mount. He needs to start working on his escapes now.
You know,
I would like to see a burst of energy now, Alex. If he just got a good, like, 5 to 10 heavy shots in. Oh, nice. Now there's some more heavier shots going in. And he's rolled out, but as he rolled into a triangle, I can't see. Ben's going for that triangle, and he can lock this up. Romain is very well trained on the floor. You can tell he's holding that right leg and stopping that triangle from happening, and he's done a great job, and now he's on top. Last 10 seconds. He managed to turn it around, but that's definitely not enough to win this round. This round goes to Ben, definitely. Very good round. Third and final round underway. Romain Roberts versus Ben. It could be about one round each right now. Nice right straight, and that's rocked Ben, that right straight. Romain should really capitalize on that.
He went for a body shot there. Look, he can see a weakness in the body. Keep it at range, keep those long range punches going. But Ben doesn't want that. Ben wants to close in and get him on the ground. He's been doing a lot more successfully. Oh, that's some power there.
Romain rushed in there and now it's going to the ground. But Ben wants to stand up. I'm shocked because I think Romain's getting the better of the stand up.
Yeah.
He might regret that. And he scores another takedown, Alex.
Wrestling needs a lot to be desired there for my Frenchman.
That's right, he's got great stand up and he's great on the floor, but the wrestling goes to Ben, definitely. And everything counts on this round, if you ask me. In my eyes, I think it's one round apiece now. So.
Let's see how hungry they really want it, how much they really want it. This is grassroots MMA. This is where generally fighters have got nothing to lose and everything to prove.
Definitely. So Ben's remains keeping a tight guard now, controlling the head, not allowing Ben to do much and hoping he's going to fall into a submission. But it's the last round of the fight and it's going to be really hard to sink in something like an armbar when they're so hot and sway. If you can find the energy to just throw down these shots a bit harder, Alex, you could really grind Romain into the ground now. And these are some good strikes going down from Ben now. 1, 2, 3, 4, they're going in. They're not the hardest shots in the world, but they are definitely doing something. There we go, nice.
and Ramon's having real trouble trying to get out of this mount. He's pretty much stuck there. Ben's taking his fight where he wants it. Oh, and a nice escape from Roberts, and he takes the back straight away. I like this matchup, Alex. It's a very even matchup. It's so back and forth. But he's landed himself on the bottom again, and now Ben's on top. Can he do something with it? This round's about to end soon, and it's down to the judges, and I would not like to be a judge on this one.
Ladies and gentlemen, the judges have conferred and we have a winner. It's a unanimous decision. To the red corner, Ben Conway!
Oh, Ben, come here, mate. You puffed out?
A little bit, yeah.
You excited?
Oh, that was very fun.
You know, that was actually very entertaining. I've emceed the biggest fights, the lowest fights, been all around the world. I found that entertaining. Why did I find that entertaining? Because I could see someone nervous, apprehensive. I know you come from a sand shell background. That's kung fu with throws. So you've got a bit of experience, but it's a little bit different to being in here. And I can see this guy's very experienced, very hungry for the win. And you've had only one fight and one loss. Yeah. How'd you feel?
I feel fantastic. I mean, he came out, he got me with that head kick right at the beginning. I was seeing stars for a minute, but Coach Wendell just shouted at me, got myself together, kept taking him down. And yeah, I think thanks to...
That's exactly what I saw. It's like a drama. You start to relax, all right, I'm getting hit. I'm in a fight. All right, I'm all right now. I'm gonna be a fight. And what I like about grassroots MMA, when you're first starting out, you try stuff. And more experienced fighters, they play it safe and play it boring. You're actually trying some things. It was really exciting to watch.
Yeah, that was a good fight. I've never done a flying knee before. Obviously, it didn't connect, and neither did his, but you've got to try it to know what it's like.
You gonna come back in here?
I hope so. If Cam will have me, then I'd love to come back, try again, fight again.
Please, just, I'm gonna teach you to put your hands up. I don't like seeing you getting hit, but it's... Hello, don't you like me anymore? Would you like to thank anyone?
Yeah, everyone at Urban Kings, especially Coach Wendell, Ash Grimshaw, all my training partners, Rog, Simon who's fighting later, and especially my great friend Jenny, who's been supportive and helpful and just generally been a fantastic little cheerleader for me.
I think it's time to go and get some beer. Go and get some beer.
I think I might just do that. Thank you.
Woo! Okay, this is our third fight, ladies and gentlemen. It's a light heavyweight competition. And introducing from the blue corner, Darren Stewart.